Hi guys, he's Peter, and as you know, I already announced you then I'm going to share with you one of my strongest and best algorithms for predicting online roulette numbers, simply predicting the possible outcome for RNG, random number generator. I will simply do this webinar, as I said, not fast. I will talk also not so fast that you can understand what I'm talking about, because it requires some kind of attention and major motivation for me to introduce you to this algorithm 3 Sigma. Is then I'm gonna inspire you to develop your maybe own app or Excel file or even a paper version of something what makes sense or is built based on the statistics and probability. And I already using them for my advantage if I play online roulette, and I'm gonna share with you as well. So I hope this will be very, let's say, interesting webinar for you. Then you can learn a lot how I work, for let's say how it works if you wanna predict online roulette numbers. And I'm sharing with you one of my strongest 3 Sigma algorithm. So enjoy it, and let's jump very quickly to the first part. So you probably heard in your lifetime something about Gauss curve, right? So I'm showing you a very simple big picture which says some, let's say, percentages, and they represent certain parts of a normal distribution if you have some kind of collected numbers or observations from real world. And actually my idea, and I say it openly, I am not using exactly like you probably also heard the term standard deviation and so on. I'm not using exactly the calculation of standard deviation for my, let's say, predicting algorithms 3 Sigma, but I'm using some smart, interesting parts, and especially how the certain number of observations can be split into parts based on Gauss curve. And I'm working with this term normal distribution, which is something what you can expect to happen. Several times it's not happening if you generate new numbers on online roulette, and for certain these areas you are actually looking for. So you can search the term if you don't know what Gauss curve is and how it works, but I will not, let's say, waste the time to explaining how the Gauss curve looks like and what is behind that. You can easily Google that in your own language, so that's I think the fastest way. And let's continue a bit more. So you have a here on the left side very quick explanation what the percentages are doing, or what is the meaning of the percentages here. And as I said, I am showing you, for example, this is the first standard deviation, how you can calculate. I'm showing you then it's some kind of mathematics behind that, but I want to make it simple. I want to make it simple, as I also know then not everyone is the math wizard, and therefore the algorithm which I'm going to share with you, I'm trying to simplify the maximum way, but still providing one of the best results what it can. So in general, you know, if you play with a French or European roulette, there are 37 numbers. And for example, if you take the first part here, if you take 37 spins on a roulette, not number spins, so some numbers are absolutely not coming. You know that some are even hitting 3 or 4 times, but in general you always have a 37 hits if we take 37 spins, right? So in general you can say expectation of hit for one particular number in 37 spins is, you know it, right? So it's one time. We expect in one time one number in 37 spins will hit. And you know from the short example above, then it's many times not the case, right? Sometimes some numbers are hitting one time, but sometimes two, three, four times, and several of them zero times, simply they didn't hit at all. So if we would have a perfect normal distribution, so all 37 numbers would hit one time in 37 spins. And I can tell you, this is probably will never ever happen. There is of course always chance from probability point of view, but in reality it's very rare to see that, mostly never, right? The probability is extremely low. So in general, if I read this sentence explaining this percentage, at least this 68%, the normal distribution is saying that if you calculate mean, which is a really mean, like an average from all hits which you had in 37 spins on roulette, and can calculate the first sigma, like first standard deviation from this mean, then you can say then 68% of numbers based on the hitting frequency will be in this range. So if you pick the picture here, so you can say that almost 70% of numbers will be in a certain range, which is calculated based on average hit. Average hit will be like 1, and if you take the boundaries on both sides, like -1 and +1 something, what you calculated like a standard deviation, then almost 70% of numbers will be in these ranges. And why it is important, you will find out very soon.